Hey beauty warriors, welcome to Battle Tested Beauty. Today we're going to talk about my Boxycharm. So I got the premium box, I've got the base box. I have some feelings about both of them. Just to get it right out of the way, way more skincare than I've ever wanted in any boxes. So just get that out of the way. I've watched a few other reviews of Boxycharms this month, and that's at least I'm not the only one. Like, a lot of people are like, can you not just do that? I want makeup. But like, I signed up for makeup. So we'll get that out of the way. Okay, base box. So the base box, as you know, they're supposed to have a minimum value of $125. This guy squeaks in at $128. So we've got in our base box, we got the Becca 24-Hour Ultimate Coverage Foundation. That guy retails for $44 American, and it's actually worth about $58.19 Canadian. We also got the Alamar complexion brushes. That's these guys here. I really like these brushes. Anyways, those retail for $36 American, and it's actually about $47.60 Canadian. And they're also some vegan, cruelty free. That's always great. We also got in the base box Ciate London Everyday Vacay Coconut Setting Powder. This retails for $22 American, which is about $29.02 Canadian. This is, ooh, I feel nice about this one. I like that one a lot. We also got First Aid Beauty Facial Radiance Pads. These guys are really cute, you know, those like sort of exfoliating and toning type pads. Those retail for $16, which is actually $21.16 Canadian. And finally, we got the Evio Beauty Evio X Aurora Refreshing Cleansing Hemp Wipes. These guys retail for $10 American, which is about $13.22 Canadian. So in this particular box, I only got two pieces of skincare. That's fantastic. Okay, I can handle that. I'm kind of not into single-use skincare. I'm trying to get away from that kind of stuff. I never was really into it to begin with because I've always been a poor bitch. So I'm not like excited about that. I won't necessarily repurchase those, but that's, anyways, we'll get to talking about that kind of stuff. Okay, so the base box. I said earlier, minimum of $125 value. This worked out to $128 American, which is $169 Canadian, more or less. Cost me $37, I think, Canadian. Americans are charged $25, free shipping within America, EU. I gotta pay for shipping. Anyways, moving on to the premium box. So this guy is supposed to have a minimum value of $175 American. This, that works out to about $230 Canadian. This thing costs $35 American. For me, though, it costs about $49, I think, after tax and shipping and all that kind of jam and exchange. And this has a value of $259 American. Mm-hmm. So that works out to $342.50 Canadian. Okay, so we got the Cara di Picante palette. Yeah, it's super warm. Yeah. We'll have thoughts. Anyway, that retails for $29 American. That's $38.35 Canadian, roughly. 21 shades in there. We also got, I love this, Glow Recipe, the Watermelon Glow Ultra Fine Mist. I really like this. It's like a refreshing, it's not quite a setting spray, but it's, I've been using it as one. That one retails for $28 American, which works up to about $37 Canadian. It's got some good stuff in there. So we got the Hourglass Diffused Heat. That one retails for $40 American, which works up to about $53 Canadian, more or less. Okay, this is the part that really pissed me the F off. Just really, really got my goat. Okay, so this Faccia Skincare, this 24-hour gold or 24K gold foil moisturizer, this retails for $100 American. Which is about $133-$132 Canadian, and it's got these little gold flecks in there. The average Karen uses more gold for her freaking gold foil and whatnot for her, like, scrapbooking and stuff. So, I mean, don't even start with that kind of shit. And it retails for $100 freaking, and this is the kind of shit that pisses me off. I got the Tarte Cosmetics Double Duty Beauty Base Tape Hydrating Primer. This thing retails for $30 American, which is a little under $40 Canadian. It's vegan, 12 hours and moisturizing and all that kind of jam. And finally, we got the Coraz Body Butter in the flavor, guava. That thing retails for $32 American, and that works out to about $42.30 Canadian. So I said my piece right at the start. I was like, fuck it, why? With the skincare. Okay, like, if you think makeup is mad overpriced. Like, if you think the jack up on makeup is insane, oh, honey, skincare is out of fucking line. On top of that, this isn't even that good of a freaking moisturizer. Like, honestly. So, editing Nicole, in the middle of doing my makeup, I look shiny and weird. Anyways, so I just watched a Jen Loves review where she's basically the 24K fachia thing. It's being sold for like $1.27 on Alibaba. There you go. There you go. That's why this shit makes me so fucking mad. So stupid. Okay, let me fix my face. Bye. You want a good moisturizer? It Confidence in this cream. That is a really good moisturizer. It's also a little pricey, I think, but it's worth it. That's really, really, really good. So that jacked my whole value up super duper high, and I don't appreciate that because I don't even like it. I didn't ask for it. And what the fuck? So they did this to me with this, with the QMS lip corrector thing, and it was like $200 fucking dollars, that value. It's junk. It doesn't do anything. It smells like freaking Elmer's school glue. It's junk, you know? So I have absolutely zero faith in getting a whole bunch of skincare from Boxycharm because this shit is ridiculous. Whew, I'm getting all ranty. I'm getting like red in the face and stuff like that. I can feel it. It's making me hot. Ah. Okay, so let's go through my base box. Okay, so we got these refreshing cleansing wipes. It's supposed to be biodegradable, which is great because this kind of stuff is really clogging up sewers and it's not great, so comfort. And it contains hemp fibers as well as cannabis seed oil, which is supposed to help with inflammation and, you know, like redness, which is inflammation anyway, so just whatever. It, you know, you don't have to wash it off or anything like that. It has like a soapy feel to it, but it dries down really quickly. This is really nice. And it, you know what? Like, it's actually a reasonable price. It's not the greatest price. I still probably wouldn't pay $10 freaking dollars or $13.22 for something like this, but it's a good product and I wouldn't wash my face with it, but I definitely would like double cleanse with this for sure. It's a nice product. Doesn't have much of a, like a strong scent or anything like that. It's pretty cool. I'm mad that I like these. Okay, I'm mad that I like these. They do have a reasonable price tag, though. I just, again, it's single-use skincare, so I'm not too into that. But moving on. It actually does make my skin feel really quite nice. I probably used about 10 of these now. And I actually do kind of notice a bit of a difference. My skin isn't less bumpy, but whatever. So this has lactic acid, glycolic acid, supposed to exfoliate and tone. So it does actually claim that regular use will smooth your skin's texture. So I'm looking forward to seeing if that's actually going to work. You know what? Honestly, I know I said what I said about all the skincare and I'm all mad about it, but I actually might repurchase these. I know what I said. I said about the freaking single use stuff, but it's actually pretty decent. I don't mind it at all. We're gonna move on to the Becca. So I put this on today. This is not an easy foundation to work with. I don't have too much of a problem with it. I don't like it. Let's just get that out of the way. I'll tell you why. I don't have too much of a problem with it because I'm used to Estee Lauder Double Wear, which is much thinner than this. This is very, very thick. But I understand that you have to mix it with something. You can't just like go, well, you can, but it doesn't look that great. Like, I don't know if you can see me. My camera kind of sucks with this kind of stuff, but I'm pretty creasy. It's not the greatest. I'm not a fan. So it's really thick. I've seen a lot of reviews of people that really, really struggled with this. Actually, you know what? I said I don't like it. I don't hate it. I like this for mixing. You mix it with stuff. Just like Double Wear, it's really doing its best to try and be a Double Wear knockoff. I think it doesn't dry down in the same way though. It stays sticky for a long time and it's very thick. So you see, like I put it on today and you'll see in my video that I spread it over my cheeks and I did one cheek at a time, like one half of my face at a time. And this is from experience of using this unmixed. It starts to dry down really, really quickly and it doesn't move well. So you need to have like a really wet sponge, not the brush. You know, I've used this a couple times with a brush. It's not awful, but I've mixed it every single time. And I really strongly recommend if you do want to use this, don't just go in with it. Mix it with something. I like mixing it with the Farsali Glass Skin. You can mix it with like any kind of like liquidy stuff. It's too thick. You need to mix it with something. It's not quite the right color. But it does claim to be 24 hours, claims to be transfer resistant, water resistant, and with breathable natural coverage. It does not have a natural coverage. This is not natural in any way, shape, or form. there's, I don't know, unless you have absolutely zero creases on your face, there is no way to keep this from creasing on you. There's no way to get this to make, like, look really, really natural without mixing it with a ton of other stuff. And it's basically another product at that point. So, I like it, but with the caveat that it has to be mixed with a bunch of crap. So, big heavy glass though. Doesn't, it smells a little bit like Play-Doh. Like, it doesn't, it has that foundation scent to it, whatever. Ciate. The Ciate Vacay, the Everyday Vacay Coconut Setting Powder. I really like this stuff. I can't smell the coconut, to be honest. I cannot smell the coconut. I'm not a big fan of coconut scent. So, you know, like, I'm watching for it and I can't smell it. It's okay. It's super finely milled. Super duper duper finely milled. It's very rare that I'll actually bake my face unless I come across something like this, which is dope. And I can actually bake with that and it doesn't look horrible. I set my eyes with it though. Like, I set my eye base down with it. That was a bad idea. Bad idea. Because that really watered out a lot of my eyeshadow when I was trying to apply that. So I don't recommend that for sure. But this really is blurring it, you know, like everything they claim about it. Finely milled, lightweight, crease-free, soft focus, finish, no flash, all that stuff. I really like this. This is definitely going to be a staple for me. Thank you very much, Boxycharm. Last items in the base box are these, ooh, there's a whole bunch of little hairs sticking out, are these here Alamar Trio, this skin trio. So far, I've liked everything that I've been sent from Alamar. Thank you, Boxycharm. I'm glad you're pumping the Alamar because they're really quite good. So we get these three brushes. I do like them all. I'm a little iffy about this guy. I don't know, it's too dense and ripply. I don't need it to be ripply to put my bronzer on or anything like that. But I mean, I've been using it. It's too thick and wide and dense, and like to get it into smaller pans was a bit of a problem. But it does blend out really, really nicely. You know, so I don't have too much of a complaint about it. I'm definitely happy about it and I'll keep it. I like it when they're tapered, even though it's a little too fat, but whatever. This guy, I mean, it's a little dense brush, I guess. Brightening brush, they call it. But wiping away your bake. I haven't used it for anything else yet, but I'm sure it has another use. And then this guy, I really, really like this brush. Yeah, my dumbass, it's like complexion brush, so I'm like, for foundation. Right? And I'm like trying really hard to get into and learn and you like just get better at using brushes to apply my foundation as well as my concealer and all that kind of stuff. So I used it for several days to apply my foundations, and I've used it on a whole bunch of them. I've used it even on the Becca. I used it today to put on my blush. I think I tried to blend out the edges of this makeup, which, oh, by the way, that Becca, it oxidizes, but it oxidizes like 30 minutes later. Okay, so my base box, I'm actually like on principle alone, I'm less mad about my base box than I am about my premium box because I got so much makeup in it and I'm happy with that. Like, thank you. Cool. I'm done with that. Thank you very much. Let's move on though. Let's move on. You know, I don't hate the premium box either. You know, like I really like this. I really, 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 really like this spray. It's not going to set anything. It's not holding your makeup down or anything like that, but it is adding a little bit of glow. It's adding a bit of life back to you after you put a whole bunch of powder on, all that jam. So it's quite nice. And if I can get it underneath my eyes a little tight, like if I'm like spraying, you know, that kind of, it really does like kind of refresh my under eye area, which is quite a dry area. So I really, really like this. It's not shiny or anything like that. Like, it doesn't have a glimmer or a sparkle or a shimmer or anything like that. So it really is ultra fine. Look at this, mister. It smells like watermelon. I know a lot of people don't like the smell of watermelon. This is like very much watermelon. It claims to be 84% watermelon, hyaluronic acid, and hibiscus AHAs. So cool. Excellent. Nice. It is, it's nice though. I'm not upset about that. The Carity palette. These aren't my colors. These are really not my colors. And this actually just screams Morphe to me. Am I crazy? I'm also kind of sick of getting palettes. Please stop sending me palettes. Like, if you're good, like, I don't, 21 shades, I don't need that. I don't need that. Especially 21 shades that I will not use. I don't. This isn't my coloring. This isn't me. This isn't me at all. I'm using it on my face today. I think I fucked it up with the Ciate, by setting with the Ciate, because I don't normally do that. I've had good experiences with this. They're not like the most pigmented or anything like that, you know, like just going straight onto your lid, you're like, that's drab. Interesting. Okay, great. I don't know if this would like show up all that well on darker skin tones either. You know, like this deepest color is bittersweet, and bittersweet actually swatched like ass. And it's just like, I don't know, they're just not like highly pigmented. The shimmers are really nice though. I particularly like the purple that I've got on my eyes. Sass. That's this guy right here. I particularly like that one. It's just like a unique purple that I don't have. I don't mind purples. I like purples. I play with purples and browns, all right, but I don't fuck with oranges and yellows or anything like that, and golds. I don't like those colors. Those don't suit me. But they don't know that, so I'm not going to blame Boxycharm for that. And some of these swatch like crap. Some of them are good. I'm probably going to give this away. I don't know. I really put a big, big dent in Sass, trying to get that onto my... Yeah. You see in the video, like, I kind of struggled to get color payoff and whatnot, and again, that could be my fault for setting with the Ciate, and it could just be too finely milled. And like, I even wiped a bunch of it off afterwards. Like, I'd already started going in with eyeshadow, and I was like, what the hell is going on here? And I ended up wiping more off with my Blendiful, and it still didn't. So I don't know, maybe that was probably me, but I'm not mad about getting it, I guess. Moving on. So the Hourglass Diffused Heat. I mean, this was a really cool thing to get in this. This, my first thought when I saw that I was getting this was like, cool. Because I've been thinking about buying some of these. I wouldn't have picked Diffused Heat if I was buying it for myself, because I knew that was a really cool pink, and that's not my jam. So unsurprisingly, I don't really like it. Like, it's a little too cool. It's a little too like bubblegummy almost. And it doesn't show up well on me until it's too much. Does that make any sense? I don't know if that makes any sense, but like, I'm really struggling to try and get this to work nicely. I don't know if you can see, like, I'm feeling really washed out with my lights in here, but I had to reapply it several times just to get it to, and I still don't know if it's enough. It's not a bad product though. Like, this isn't terrible. I'm not too big on like glowing or shimmery or glittery blushes. But this isn't like, it's not over the top or anything like that, so I'm not mad about it. I'm just glad I got some more makeup. Thanks. Okay, so this Faccia skincare. I mean, I went on my rant earlier. I went on a rant a little bit. I've used it every day, twice a day. Like I said earlier, this contains less gold foil than some average Karen is going to use on a weekend scrapbooking that she bought from Michaels for like $4. Honestly. Choke on my tits. You're out of your mind. It also has the most unnatural, unhealthy texture. It's like that shit that drips out of alien spit. Yeah. Yeah, kind of strongly scented as well too. Oh, no, I'm mad about it. You know what? I think a lot of people are really happy about it, but I'm kind of mad about it. Stop jacking up the damn cost, like the value of these things, with stuff that sucks. Come on. And I'm annoyed too, because I saw reviews and people are like, oh my god, this is so bullshit. Thank you so much. Like, you don't fucking fall for this shit. You're falling for it. They're just assigning value to this. It's not even good. Okay, moving on. Moving on. Tarte. So I got this guy. I put it only on half of my face today because I had this feeling that this was making my lines worse. And it turns out it was the Becca, which it'll do. It'll settle in all your lines. But anyways, so I have it only on this side of my face. I don't notice a huge difference. Let me get a mirror. Oh god, I'm so pale. You know what? My fine lines look a little bit nicer on this side, I think. But for the most part, my absolute crevices are pretty much the same on both sides. Actually, no. This side is worse. This side, the no primer side is worse. I honestly thought the base tape was making my fine lines way worse, and it really wasn't that. And this confirmed it today. I think that's a really good primer. I'm not a primer person. I don't fuck with primers unless they do a thing, you know, like if it adds a glow, or if it, you know, like the Farsali powder, liquid powder thing. if it, you know, has an effect of some sort. But typically, like, especially those ones with, with the silicone, I hate those things. Those are the worst. Those are really awful for my skin, make me break out, and they just feel awful. My skin slips around. It's just not for oily skin. This, though, this does not have any of that. It goes in like cream, like just like a moisturizer. It's really, really great product. Highly recommend that thing. I'm happy about that. And to be honest, these two things are pretty much the only items that are carrying, they're carrying the whole premium box for me, because the rest of it, ugh. Anyways, last item that I got was this Cora's body butter. So this is supposed to be guava scented. Smells like Dollarama. It's nice though. Like, don't let me shit on it just because I don't like the smell. It smells cheap, I guess. This is actually a really nice formula. Like, it's really thick. It takes a while to really sink in, but about 10 minutes, it is going to sink into your skin really, really nicely. So I do actually really, really recommend it. That is the contents of my boxes. Do I like them? Yes, I like the base box. The base box made me happy. The premium box, I don't know. I feel like they were really stretching to try and make value out of that one. But I also feel like I'm really shitting on them because this stuff is great. This is high value, and I might not have liked the color all that much, but I know that this is really, really, really valuable to a lot of people. Like, this is well sought after. They're not a bad product or anything like that. I don't like it as much. These are the guys that I really like about all of this. I have a bad taste in my mouth because of this in my premium box. I don't want this kind of stuff. Like, straight up, I don't have any faith that this is actually going to perform at its value. Does that make any sense? It's $100?
$1.27 on Alibaba.
No. And I'm really sorry, Fatia Beauty or Fatia Skincare. I've never even heard of you before, but you are digging in a mine that is already tapped. Don't. Base box, yes. Premium box, not so much this month. Let's wrap it up. Okay, guys, thank you so much for joining me today. I hope to see you soon, very, very soon, in another video, very, very soon. Hey, guys, mwah. Bye. Thank you so much for joining me today, beauty warriors. That was awkward. What if I was like sitting in a food court somewhere and just went, oh, a giant roach. My cat is obsessed with roaches, like not like cockroaches, but like joint roaches. And he will chase them. He will take them out of the ashtray and chase them all around the apartment. Eat the roach, like eat what's inside of it, and then just like chase the rest of it around, and it's in weird places. But anyways, I found that.